For f of x equals 2x, what is the translation and new function for f of x minus 1? So we have f of x equals 2x. What we're doing is we're taking 1 away from the inputs. So how do you do that? Instead of an input of x, you do an input of x minus 1. That way you're taking 1 away from the input before you're multiplying by 2. So it's going to be 2 in parentheses x minus 1. So f of x minus 1 takes 1 away from the input, and then you apply the function. Well, that's what we're doing here. Take away 1, multiply by 2. Now let's get the calculator and compare the graphs. First of all, I have to clear out the old ones, so I'm going to go to y equals, and then clear, down arrow, clear. Back up, first line, y1 is 2x. And y2, I'm just going to enter it the same way as it's written there, 2 parentheses x minus 1. You could distribute it first if you wanted to. I'm just going to leave it like this. Then let's look at the graph. Okay, so I'm looking at these lines, and I notice a couple things. One thing is it could be shifted down 2. Another thing is it could be shifted right 1. So how do you know which one it is? Well, with these lines, it's hard to tell. And I could guess, well, because it's x minus 1, a change of 1 is what I'd be looking for, so it's probably to the right. What I'm going to do is use a different type of a function to investigate further. So I'm going to go to y equals, and then clear both of these out. Now I'm going to use x squared, so I know x squared is not a line. So you x and then squared. And let's see what happens there. So I have x squared, and then we're taking 1 away from the input, so I'm going to have open parentheses, x minus 1, close parentheses, and then squared. So that's f of x minus 1 for x squared. Okay, then I'm going to hit graph. Okay, now this makes it a little more clear. The original parabola goes through the origin 0, 0. F of x minus 1 goes through this point of 1, 0, so it's 1 to the right. Now that confirms what I was saying earlier about the 1 to the right. And in fact, this is the pattern for all functions. If you take away 1 from the input using x minus 1 as a translation, you're going to go right 1. Oh, and for this new function, I can distribute out this 2 to make it a little cleaner. So f of x minus 1 equals 2 times x, which is 2x, and then 2 times negative 1, which is negative 2. So there's a new function and the translation.